Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as you do each and every Thursday at 20 past the second hour. Don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter. The way you get his newsletter, the opening call, you come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to hit newsletters. As you hit newsletters, you're going to see the opening call right on the right-hand side. You can hit view. Bottom line, you can hit subscribe. You're going to see the opening call. You get the opening call for 1 month for $128. You can get it for 6 months for $595. That's $173 savings. You can get it for a year for $995, which is a $541 savings. They all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, folks. Check it out right in the front page of TFNN. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hello?
I got you now.
Okay. How are you doing?
Good, man. Good.
Good. A very interesting moment we're at right in this particular closing price. It's the end of February, so you've got a monthly candle here on the Dow. You see over this side?
Yeah.
On the right side chart. Very good. Look, 25,915. Well, 16 is it? 16. And the all-time high is 26,951. But there are a lot of signs that are saying that it's getting harder and harder for the Dow to break out right at this moment. Let me see if I can move this chart. Yep. And if you go to the left side, back in December the 3rd, there was a little doji spike to the upside at 25,980. And if you go a little further back, on the 8th of November, the high was 26,277. We went right in between. We went to 26,241. We had three little doji candles. Even today was a fairly narrow candle. And what I drew in is this pattern, and it says this particular channel, which is, it's sometimes difficult to recognize until it's almost too late to say, now what do we do? Because this is the kind of channel where every time it bumped into that green resistance line, you could actually have bought it because it was going to go right back to that green line after it went down to the pink line. And now it's at that pink line, except this time you finally, on January the 3rd of this year, the Dow went above the, right here, above the 14 and the 9 period exponential moving averages, the MACD crossed positive. And that green line, which is the 9-period differential, this is what I call the fast-moving average of the, in this particular case, it's the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence, had not crossed negative until right here. Today was the first day, -3. That's the first time that little green, and it's just very slight.
Yeah.
But it's coming right as the Dow has support at 25,000, right here at 900. And then the very next one's around about 25,770. So we're becoming a little cautious. We've got a lot of long positions in our for my subscribers to my opening call. And I said in my Traders Corner, that's the page that has all the different positions, what we're looking at, where we're putting in stops or buy stops, whatever it is. I said today that we're going to get a little cautious. For 3 days, we've had a particular level on the Dow that we said if it gets to that level at a certain time, we want to start taking certain positions, cautionary positions. And it never, yesterday it just missed it, day before just missed it, and today it went there exactly when I wanted it. And now what we're looking at is, it doesn't say you can't bounce. And this is a pattern that I'd shown on my show at noon every day. I do a detailed technical analysis based on my Chapman Wave methodology. And I'm just trying to think when it was. I know it was before last weekend. I'd drawn a pattern. I said, my experience with this very narrow up chance, like a tube. Let's imagine it's a glass tube, finished tube that goes all the way up. And you've got a little worm that just keeps wiggling on its way up like it's walking on a branch. When it breaks that support, and this is Viva Systems Inc., cloud-based business solutions, it did exactly the same thing as the Dow. Actually, it was a spectacular run. It went from 72 to the most recent high of 124. I'd say a double is not bad since December the 26th.
That's great.
Anyway, so this is the pattern I drew. I'm going to put it right here at the edge, and you'll see there are two little doji candles. And then I said, if it takes out that key support, the pattern that my experience tells me from years and years of looking at these charts is that when this very narrow channel, you don't see a massive smash to the downside. What you see is And now I drew this gray dashed line, and I said, you see a pullback? You see a rally that might or might not just take out the previous high, and then you start to see a deeper decline. So what I'm anticipating now is that we start to see a wilder move in the down, the S&P and the Qs and the IWM. It doesn't say that you have to crash to the downside, but it does say now starts the consolidation phase, and it should be pretty wild. And you can see what happened with Viva when it took out the MACD, crossed negative after being positive for so long, you started to get that choppiness. So what I'm saying is, so for subscribers to my opening call, we've become somewhat cautious. There are a couple of positions, we now some short positions, and I'm saying we need to see the MACD widen so the green line goes sharply below the red line. That will say we've got momentum to the downside. If it's just narrow, you're just going to get a little chop, chop, chop to the downside. So it's a process. You look at the middle chart, that's the weekly chart. Look at this spectacular V-shaped pattern bumping into resistance. And my guess is that next week we actually see a peak A. That means no new high. You're not supposed to say that. Don't tell the market, but I'm saying that I don't think the Dow's going above 26,241, at least for the next week or two, because I think we're going to make a peak with a lower high next week. But you can see the technicals in the weekly chart are very strong. So that's what I've been saying, that I think we have a consolidation, whether it's time or price or time and price. I just won't know until we can break these support levels. How we break them is important, but there's a really very good support in the weekly chart in the Dow around about the 25,200 to 25,000 level. So this is a very important period. Remember, we were talking about the dollar, and the dollar is actually holding pretty well when you think about it. It's after what gold did. But I always talk about this. I say sometimes for about 6 weeks, two or three times a year, you'll get gold and the dollar actually going in the same direction. Look, they're both coming down. And then they start to go back to the counterpoint where one goes up and the other goes down. This is very important. If the dollar's able to get to 96.75 by Tuesday or Wednesday of next week, that's going to be good action. If it breaks down under 95.50, I have to say, whoops, maybe it can last a lot longer. So this is a very important period.
Yeah, and you know, we look at this market, Basil, you can see, I mean, we've actually been in a consolidation since January of 2018.
You know, if you're talking about the dollar.
No, I'm talking about the market, the Dow Industrials.
Oh, yeah, correct. Yeah. Yes, that's right.
Yeah, I mean, it's a wide consolidation, folks. I mean, so, you know, we'll see where this baby shakes out. But you know,
the other thing I wanted to mention is, I spoke about this last week, is that I think that the TLT is very important here, bonds. My chart says that bonds at 120 right now, this is a TLT.
Yeah.
If they break 119, I'm looking at the TNX, the 10-year, and I think that the Fed is going to get their way without actually doing anything. Looks to me like these yields want to go a little higher. So that could be part of the inflationary thing that they might be thinking of. The market might help them out.
And folks, you can check out Basil every trading day right here, 12 to 1. Come over to our website, TFNN, go into newsletters, you see the opening call, you can subscribe right here, right now. Basil, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Tom. You too.
Stay right there, folks. Come right back.